In my opinion, racism is the thorn in the flesh of all people of color, especially black people. It is a chronic disease that has inflicted our nation, our country, our cities, our towns, our communities, and it's something that most definitely we need to come together as a people and not stand for this any longer. It's been generation after generation that we've been afflicted with this disease, and it's time for a healing.
Pam Powell is coming.
Yes, we gotta go. Pam Powell's coming.
Pam Powell's coming. Hold on.
Pam Powell's coming.
She's coming.
Pam Powell's coming.
Who's Pam Powell? I'm Pam Powell, the host of the new Pam Powell Show. Are you broke, busted, and disgusted? Have you robbed Peter to pay Paul and they both ran out of money? Have you been lied on, cheated on, hated on? Well, it's time to get it on.
You are my ministry. You are my help me too. When I think about loving myself, I think about loving you. You are my doing me right, my spiritual song in the night, a special part of
this book right here that I'm holding in my hand, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Any Obstacle, will change your life and allow you to experience the thrill of victory rather than the agony of defeat in any situation. You know they tell us we're either going into a problem or coming out of one. Want to come out? Want to overcome obstacles? Want to win and experience the thrill of victory? Well, I'll tell you what, you need to get a copy of this book, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Obstacles, at www.pampowellempowers.com. Again, that's www.pampowellempowers.com, and it will change your life. Welcome back. I am so honored today to have a very special guest. I'm talking about none other than Senator Geraldine Thompson. That's right. Senator Geraldine Thompson represents District 12 in the state of Florida. And I tell you, she's no stranger to racial issues. She grew up in a segregated environment. And boy, she has made it to the top in terms of representing our people. She has served as a special leader at Valencia Community College for many years. She was the assistant to the president. She worked with Equal Opportunity Affairs. She has done so much, and she even founded a museum called the Wells Built Museum for African American History right here in all of Central Florida. I welcome to the Pam Powell Show, Senator Geraldine Thompson.
How are you?
Welcome to the show, Senator.
Thank you.
I'm so honored. You do so many things for people all over the country, and I'm honored that you would allow us to get up close and personal with you right here on the Pam Powell Show. And today we're talking race in America.
And I'm glad to be here. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much. I love your office. We took a tour on the way in. We're going to go down to the museum and check that out before we leave. But Senator, tell me, what are your thoughts right now on racism? Is there a race problem in America today?
Well, race has always been an issue in the United States. When the United States was founded, and we know that all men are created equal, well, when that was written, it wasn't really a reality because women were considered the property of their fathers and then later their husbands.
All right.
African Americans were considered 3/5 of a human being. And Native Americans were not considered at all. So from the very inception, race has been an issue, and it hasn't changed a great deal in terms of race being a factor in how decisions are made in the United States.
Seems like, my goodness, social media has just really brought it on. People are very opinionated about it and so forth. And then right now, I mean, we're dealing with the Bland case, and we've dealt with the Garner case and the police brutality that people are saying that's going on. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, with the Bland case in particular, who stops an individual for not signaling a lane change? This young woman is on her way to a new position, and she is stopped by law enforcement because she did not signal that she was going to change lanes. And then it escalated from there to an arrest, mm-hmm. and then to incarceration, where she is in prison for 3 days, and now we're told that she hung herself with a plastic garbage bag that was in the cell.
Okay.
And so there are a lot of questions. I filed a bill to require law enforcement to wear body cams and to have them on at all times, because I think that would take away a lot of the speculation. If you're required to wear a body cam and to have it on, then there's a recording, there's a video of what happened. I think it would be good for law enforcement as well as good for the citizens. And so I think because of technology, we're now being able to monitor what's going on.
Right, the exposure. And yes. I tell you, it's coming out more and more. What have been your most bizarre experience that you've had to deal with as an African-American leader, as an African-American senator, as someone who has always had high expectations for making difference in the lives of others? What would you consider your most bizarre incident in terms of a racial issue?
Well, very recently, I was in Tallahassee for a special session to deal with the budget.
Now, you say recently
very
in 2015?
Within the last several months, I was there. And I was seated with another African-American legislator and a staff member, three African-Americans seated together. A very new member of the Florida House of Representatives came into the room, passed a number of people, and came to us and asked if we could get her copies of the documents that were going to be reviewed during that meeting.
Wow.
And I'm thinking of all the people that she passed. Why would you assume that we're the people who are here
right.
to make sure?
In other words, pretty much, you were the servants at that meeting. You were not the senator, you were the servant. How do we resolve that, Senator?
Well, you have to be willing to speak up. And certainly, you can't fix every person that you meet who has a distorted idea of what's going on. But you have to be willing to speak up.
Do you feel that it's ever going to be another African-American president in your lifetime, based on what we've had to deal with how our president has been mistreated?
Well, I'm hoping to live a long and productive life. And so I think so. I think that there is an opportunity, and certainly we have an opportunity next year to elect the first female president of the United States.
All
so
right.
We're seeing some change and more inclusion.
You are my ministry. You are my help me too. When I think about loving myself, I think about loving you. You are my doing me right. My spiritual song in
you to tune in each and every Wednesday at 6 p.m. to the Women's Network. That's right. And check out the Pam Powell Show. And also on Saturdays, that's right, at 5 p.m. go to the Holy Connection. And you'll see all the information right here on the screen. But you need to tune into the Pam Powell Show so you can get to the T.O.P.
Pam Powell is coming.
Yes, we gotta go. Pam Powell's coming.
Pam Powell's coming. Hold on.
Pam Powell's coming.
She's coming.
Pam Powell's coming.
Who's Pam Powell? I'm Pam Powell, the host of the new Pam Powell Show. Are you broke, busted, and disgusted? Have you robbed Peter to pay Paul and they both ran out of money? Have you been lied on, cheated on, hated on? Well, it's time to get it on.
Thank you so much, Senator Thompson, for all you do. And thank you for being on the Pam Powell Show.
Glad to be here.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back. More guests to talk about race. In fact, we're hitting the streets. We're stopping traffic because we want to know how people feel about race in America. And you know, the Hope Doctor's in, and we're going to solve some racial problems on the Pam Powell Show. We'll be right back. Don't you touch the dial.
Pam Powell.
Be motivated and inspired as Pam Powell illustrates the power of the P Factors. Start a new and wonderful life with the help of this amazing book. Order your copy of Pam Powell's book, The P Factor, today at www.pampowell.org. Pam Powell is also available for speaking engagements. Visit her website at pampowell.org.
This book right here that I'm holding in my hand, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Any Obstacle, will change your life and allow you to experience the thrill of victory rather than the agony of defeat in any situation. You know they tell us we're either going into a problem or coming out of one. Want to come out? Want to overcome obstacles? Want to win and experience the thrill of victory? Well, I'll tell you what, you need to get a copy of this book, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Obstacles, at www.pampowellempowers.com. Again, that's www.pampowellempowers.com, and it will change your life.
In my opinion, racism is the thorn in the flesh of all people of color, especially black people. It is a chronic disease that has inflicted our nation, our country, our cities, our towns, our communities, and it's something that most definitely we need to come together as a people and not stand for this any longer. It's been generation after generation that we've been afflicted with this disease, and it's time for a healing.
Welcome back. I am excited about our next guest, and I'm talking none other than a powerful businessman in all of Central Florida, none other than Mr. John Crossman. That's right. He is the owner of a firm that has real estate all over the Southeast Florida, 22 million square feet. He's been in the Wall Street Journal, Money Magazine. He has foundations. He's also contributed so much to Bethune-Cookman College. He's worked with Florida A&M University. But the key is he is passionate about people coming together. And we wanted him to talk race right now on the Pam Powell Show. He is also the son of the late Reverend Ken Crossman, who did so much for this community. Welcome to the Pam Powell Show, Mr. John Crossman.
I'm honored.
All right. We're just so excited about having you. And we also wanted to take a look from another perspective outside of the African-American perspective about race in America. Sure. What are your thoughts about racism? Does racism exist in America today?
Well, it does, but the conversation is changing, if I could talk about that a little.
Yeah, let's talk.
I'll tell you what's really, I think you might find interesting. I talk a lot to business leaders, CEOs, and I ask the question, do you know racist people or do you see racism? And 100%, 90%, 100% will say, I don't know any racist.
Like, really?
Interesting. Now, I'll meet other people that will tell me, oh, there's a lot of racists in this country. And then I'll say to them, well, name them. Like, who specifically?
Okay.
And I have trouble naming them, those sorts of concepts. So what's the truth in that? And I think the truth is, I think that we're better than we've ever been as a nation, where we have more and more people that are enlightened, that want diversity, that are open. And yet we still have institutions of racism that are still in control. Does that make sense?
Of course. So, I understand.
So I think the dialogue change needs to stop being personal, like, well, you're racist or you're that kind of talk, to more there's situational or institutional racism, which we can work together and address those and make it better for everybody. I've worked with 30 universities across the country, from USC, UCLA, all the way over to Wharton, to Florida State and UCF, and lots of great students. But if I had you come with me, and you were with me as we visited all these schools, and I said, let's go back to just one. There's one school that is, there's a gap between how their students perform when I meet with them than all of those other prestigious schools. And that school is Florida A&M.
Wow.
The students are exceptional.
Mm-hmm.
That's good news. But what's the bad news is, I meet so many people that don't know that. They're not aware of that. And so I meet companies that they tell me they want diversity, they're seeking diversity, but they're not recruiting at FAMU, and then they're not recruiting at Bethune-Cookman, which is also another great school, because they're not aware of them. So that's really the divide. It's not as much I see it racist, like people saying, well, I'm not going to recruit those schools. It's that they're not aware of it. So that's one of my goals, is to make sure that the business community, the business owners, particularly in Central Florida, when you're thinking about hiring students, go after these historically black colleges, because there's tremendous talent there. And one last just quick opening thought on that is that sometimes people just talk about diversity. Here's what I always tell people: diversity. Diversity never lowers the bar. Diversity widens the net. And so if you want the most exceptional, best business students, you got to go find them.
Of course.
Some will come easy. But other ones, you need to go find them. And if you're looking for great students, FAMU, Bethune-Cookman has some of the best I've ever seen.
As an African-American woman who really cares about my people,
right,
who really cares about our country and right, everyone in general, because I love people.
Right.
From your perspective, I want to get this last question and I want you to answer, because on the Pam Powell Show, we like to keep it 100.
I like it.
All right?
Sure.
Looking at other cultures, looking at the Caucasian culture,
right,
and how some of them begin to still look at African Americans as second-class citizens. Not all, but some. Mm-hmm. I want you to look into the camera, John, mm-hmm, and I want you to just talk as if you were having a meeting, mm-hmm, with people of your culture, mm-hmm, and give them a one-minute speech on how we can come together to embrace all races. Would you do that?
Sure. I would say this. We are all tied together in one community. We are all one family, and we rise and fall together. If any segment of our community is disenfranchised, is having problems, it affects all of us. If you are a devout environmentalist, you should care about parts of your community that are suffering because it's bad for the environment. If you're a devout capitalist, you should care because it's bad for the economy. If you're a person of faith, you should care because your faith calls you to do that. And if we all work on it together, we're all going to rise up together. We have no ability as a successful people to sit and watch TV or look at the internet and complain or post random comments or rants. What we can do is take positive steps to help out and make an impact. And when we do, we make a better world for all of us.
Well, you heard it right here on the Pam Powell Show from a businessman. And I'm talking about someone who's really involved, not someone who's just talking, but who's really involved in wanting to make a difference in the African-American community. We thank you so much, John, for being on the Pam Powell Show. I look forward to getting with you on future activities. And we look forward to making a difference and impacting our nation in terms of racism in America to more positive things. Thank you so much. And stay tuned, we'll be right back. We have a very special guest who is the president of the Black Caucus, that's right, of Orange County. I'm talking about none other. Y'all know him from Omega Sci-Fi. You know who I'm talking about, a man who's made a name for himself, Mr. Russell Drake. And I heard he got some purple on. Stay tuned, we will be right back.
Be motivated and inspired as Pam Powell illustrates the power of the P factors. Start a new and wonderful life with the help of this amazing book. Order your copy of Pam Powell's book, The P Factor, today at www.pampowell.org. Pam Powell is also available for speaking engagements. Visit her website at pampowell.org.
This book right here that I'm holding in my hand, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Any Obstacle, will change your life and allow you to experience the thrill of victory rather than the agony of defeat in any situation. You know they tell us we're either going into a problem or coming out of one. Want to come out? Want to overcome obstacles? Want to win and experience the thrill of victory? Well, I'll tell you what, you need to get a copy of this book, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Obstacles, at www.pampowellempowers.com. Again, that's www.pampowellempowers.com, and it will change your life.
America, racism, all day long. When the black man go to court, the first thing the white man use against him is his history. When the black man asks the white man about his history, what he did to us, he tell us to move on. How we gonna move on? It's racism. Racism all day long in America. You can't get around it at all. That's why Donald Trump is winning the race right now. Because all the white people think just like him. He's not lying. He tried the same thing they used talking about the Mexicans. That's for the black people. Now they say they can't use the black people no more, so they're using the Mexicans. But the Mexicans are smarter and start overvoting where we stop voting. And that's why they mad at the Mexicans. Racism all day long.
Welcome back to the Pam Powell Show. And I am so excited because I'm sitting right here in the historical Wells Built Museum. That's right, where African American history is all over the place from my beginning right here in Orlando, Florida. But the special guest that I'm excited that's going to talk about racism in America today is none other than the president, that's right, of the Democratic Black Caucus of all of Orange County. He's a former president of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity, wearing his purple today. I'm telling you, a man who's a community leader, a voice for the people, none other than my friend, that's right, Russell Drake. Welcome to the Pam Powell Show.
Thank you for having me.
I am so excited. Man, you're looking good in that now. I need to borrow that for my husband. How about it?
Absolutely.
But listen, you know, we're talking about race in America, and we've been talking to people on the street and getting information about what people feel. But how are you feeling right now? Is there true racism going on in America today?
I believe beyond a shadow of a doubt, there is true racism in America. It may not be fueled by everybody, but there are forces who are fueling racism and have been doing so for more than two centuries, as far as I'm concerned.
So you feel that people now no longer wear the white whatever garments. They are now just in business suits and doing the same thing. How did it affect you, the Charleston killings and the shootings there in that church? How did that affect you being a president of the caucus? How did that really get to you?
It really had me solve. I mean, first, prayers go all out to the family.
Yes, yes, yes. But I went to that. It was the funeral services for the pastor. It was just incredible. But we're always seeming as if we're people to forgive.
Right. And I do believe in the end we should forgive, but I think the first thing that needs to be acknowledged is there was some wrong done. There was some incorrect things done. There's a bad systemic problem that needs to get highlighted. I think too much things get swept under the rug, like, oh, this is an isolated incident, when it's clear that the person said his ideologies led him to this, and there are others who practice those same ideologies.
Right.
He's not alone in his thinking, and I think that is really the worst thing, is people try to sweep it under the rug, mm-hmm, and say, this is just a random thing. But no, it was calculated.
All right. Well, you know, most of the, even when you look at Dr. King, everything was pretty much organized and all of that through the churches. What has been the most bizarre incident when you look at your life that has happened to you? Even right now in 2015, driving while black, what?
I've had a lot of incidents to occur. I will say that. I think during the year of 2008, when Barack Obama was running for president,
uh-huh,
and I had several Barack Obama stickers on my car, I don't think it was by coincidence that I got stopped more than double-digit times.
Okay.
I don't think it was by accident. I mean, I was getting stopped every week.
You know? So everywhere you went, you were stopped by perhaps officers for whatever because you had that sticker. So you know, Russ, we have our marches, we have our rallies, and you know, the president's song, Amazing Grace, and all that. But what do we do now? How do we solve these issues? What are your thoughts on solving the racial problem that exists in America? How can we do that?
Well, I think it's several ways. I think one is in education first.
Okay.
Persons have to truly know thyself. Persons need to take advantage of places like the Wells Built Museum, where they can learn about not just history of Orlando, but African American history. Then they got to seek it on themselves. I think churches play a great part too. I mean, if you look at it back in the 60s, churches is where a lot of movements and educational sessions started. You know, people who don't have knowledge themselves are destined to repeat the mistakes of the past. So I think first it's in education. Second, it's in those people who do have the education to formally make notice of it, make action. Don't just sit back and say, I know this is going on, and shrug their shoulders, but mm-hmm, let it be known, we got a problem here.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody needs to be saying, we got a problem. There's a movement called Black Lives Matter, and we know that Black Lives Matter. There's some other people that know that Black Lives Matter, and they should stop acting like they don't know. Then it does come to those who are in elected office. I mean, we need to talk about policies preventing some things from happening.
Well, I want to thank you so much for being on the Pam Powell Show.
Absolutely.
Oh, wow. We just really enjoyed your message today. And I just want to say, together we stand, divided we fall. All for one, one for all on the Pam Powell Show. And I just believe that we can come together and cure racism in America. I'm reminded of what my daddy would always tell me when things seemed impossible. Somebody said that it couldn't be done. But she would have chuckled to reply that maybe it couldn't. But she'd be one who wouldn't say no till she tried. She buckled in with a bit of a grin, and if she worried, she hit it. And she started to sing as she tackled that thing that couldn't be done. And with God's help, guess what? We did it. All right, now, you've been watching the Pam Powell Show. We'll see you now at the TOP, because that's where God wants all of us to be. We're out.
Evangelist Allison Moore Smith has released her sixth book titled, He Rescued Me. This book has been written to give hope to the hopeless after receiving a bad diagnosis from the doctor. This book will also take your faith from a mustard seed and increase it to a mustard tree. The cost for this book is only $8. You must read this bestseller. Buy one for yourself or for someone that is going through a health crisis. For more information, call Allison at 407-334-6964 or log on to www.moreimages.com.
You are my ministry. You are my
show. It is designed to inspire our communities across the world with hope. And that's exactly what this show is doing. And that's exactly what this world needs with the things that are going on today. With Pam Powell, I had a chance to get to know her on a little personal level, with knowing how ambitious she was and how she didn't let any of her obstacles to hinder her from pursuing her goals. She's an author of 2 books. And I encourage you highly to take a look at those books on her website. In fact, you can go to www.pampowellempowers.com. There, you can discover how you can book her for speaking engagements. She's also a branding expert, a motivational speaker, and she's also a talk show host, of course, as you see today. And if you're interested in being on her show, you can definitely be a guest on her show. Just go to her website again, www.pampowellempowers.com. We hope to see you tune in again, same time, same place, next week on The Pam Powell Show. Be blessed.
Pam Powell is coming!
Yes, we gotta go! Pam Powell's coming!
Pam Powell's coming! Hold on.
Pam Powell's coming.
She's coming.
Pam Powell's coming.
Who's Pam Powell? I'm Pam Powell, the host of the new Pam Powell Show. Are you broke, busted, and disgusted? Have you robbed Peter to pay Paul and they both ran out of money? Have you been lied on, cheated on, hated on? Well, it's time to get it on.
This book right here that I'm holding in my hand, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Any Obstacle, will change your life and allow you to experience the thrill of victory rather than the agony of defeat in any situation. You know they tell us we're either going into a problem or coming out of one. Want to come out? Want to overcome obstacles? Want to win and experience the thrill of victory? Well, I'll tell you what, you need to get a copy of this book, The 7 Principles of Overcoming Obstacles, at www.pampowellempowers.com. Again, that's www.pampowellempowers.com, and it will change your life.
Be motivated and inspired as Pam Powell illustrates the power of the P factors. Start a new and wonderful life with the help of this amazing book. Order your copy of Pam Powell's book, The P Factor, today at www.pampowell.org.
Pam Powell is coming!
Yes, we gotta go! Pam Powell's coming!
Pam Powell's coming!
Pam Powell's coming.
She's coming.
Pam Powell's coming.
Who's Pam Powell? I'm Pam Powell, the host of the new Pam Powell Show. Are you broke, busted, and disgusted? Have you robbed Peter to pay Paul and they both ran out of money? Have you been lied on, cheated on, hated on? Well, it's time to get it on.